Abu Dhabi,
we thank you,
e toma tour control,
and take over full control,
in nome di Cristo Gesù,
in the name of Jesus Christ,
amen,
amen.
Tonight
we're going to discuss how to edify your
faith.
We heard a lot of times about a message of faith. You need to have faith. But what is this faith? If I don't have it, how do I get it? Or if I have it, I'm not seeing the result. Where is the problem? Before we start, I want us to go to Hebrews 11.
Aquí nada más pone es un amplificado, se está explique hope más amplio.
Here I put an amplified because it broadens it out, the explanation.
Esta pista.
And it says.
Is sin fe.
And now without faith.
That impossible.
It is impossible.
Para agradar.
To please.
Y satisfacer Dios.
And satisfy God.
Es un cumplir cerca Dios.
The one that comes to God.
Me esté necesariamente quiere.
Must necessarily believe.
Por Dios está existiendo.
That God exists.
Y puta esta es un.
And that He is the one.
Puta recompensar.
That will reward.
Esclando seriamente y diligentemente.
Those that seriously and diligently. Are seeking for Him. Now we have seen that without faith it is impossible to please God. We as Christians need to have faith so we can please God. And now the question, what is faith? We all know this verse already. Let us go to Hebrews 11,
versículo 1.
Verse 1. Here I also use the amplified version that is broader.
Our faith is segurança.
Now faith is the assurance.
É confirmação.
The hope.
É título de propriedade.
The title of propriety. Of title.
De coisa que nos espera arriba.
Of the things that we hope for.
Sendo a prova.
Being the proof
of
the things that we do not see,
e convicción na realidad,
and the conviction of their reality.
Faith percibe como hecho real,
faith can be perceived as something real,
lo que no ahora revela,
what has not been revealed,
na es cinco sentido na de cada uno de nos.
To the five sentences of every one of us. It is very important to put attention to the words that I underline here, because these are the basic foundation of the teaching of tonight. You need to have the assurance. You need the confirmation and the conviction of their reality when you are not seeing something. Faith is a substance. Substance for what you are hoping for. And now it's impossible to say I'm hoping for something and I don't see it. But we as Christians have the substance that God has given to every one of us. So we can bring into reality the things that our sentences doesn't see or feel. What is faith?
Faith nos confianza.
Faith is our confidence.
Nos segurança.
Our assurance.
Y confirmação.
And our confirmation. Of what we do not see.
Faith is real.
Faith is real.
Pero nos nota mira en físico.
But we don't see it in the physical.
I
also said that faith is the spiritual substance of the things that we are hoping for,
evidencia,
and the evidence of the things that we do not see.
Faith nasce e cresce fuori e palavra di Dio.
Faith is being born and will grow from the word of God. In John 1:1, the word says, in the beginning was the word. The word was with God. And the word was God. Faith, as we have seen in the beginning, is the confidence that we have in God. Here we see that faith is being born and grows from the word of God.
Es palabra de Dios que Dios mismo.
The word of God is God himself.
Y fe que nos tiene.
And the faith that we have
de fe que nos tiene de Dios.
Is the faith we have in God.
De nada otro.
In nothing else.
No de amor humana, de
not
nada
in your
otro.
Brethren, in nothing else.
De Dios.
In God.
Y una vez que tienes confianza en Dios.
And once you have confidence in God.
Y Dios está su palabra.
And God is his word.
Automatically.
The faith and the confidence we have need of
realidad,
to bring into reality
nos nota, mira,
the things that we do not see
nos fuente,
we have to get it from the source
nos
of the one that we are believing in
Dios.
And that is God.
Amen.
Amen.
Mundo,
the world
siempre me se mira algo,
always has to see something in order to believe.
Pero nos no está perteneciendo al mundo.
But we do not belong to that world.
Nos está quiere.
We believe.
Nos está confía.
We have confidence.
Y ahora nos está
ahí. And then we receive.
Por eso esta nos fe.
Because that is our faith.
Nos confianza en Dios.
Our confidence is in God.
Puda agrade.
That will please him.
Adora nos agrada a Dios.
And when we please God.
Me supongo ahora nos está meta.
Just also like when someone is pleasing us,
nos quiere hacer todo cosa posible.
We want to do everything possible.
Pero persona es sintiéndole bon.
So that the person can feel good.
Para botar es sentirlo contento.
So you can also be happy.
Pero persona está sintiéndole bon.
That a person is feeling good.
Amen.
Amen.
Mundo me se mira para querer.
The world has to see in order to believe.
Pero en Habacuc 2:4.
But in Habacuc 2:4.
Es palabra de Dios nos haga nos bailar.
Let us go there.
It
says how the just has to live.
It
says that the just has to live by faith.
The
just will live by faith. We are the just, the righteousness of God. And we have to live believing in God. I want us to understand that faith is the confidence in God. And we can also apply it in the natural. When you have confidence in someone, you can share everything with a person, and you also know that that person will do everything possible for you. Knowing that the faith
de confianza en Dios
is the confidence in God,
es importante para nosotros, ¿qué es la confianza?
It is also very important to know what is confidence.
Confianza de combustible.
Confidence is the gasoline
para la palabra de Dios.
For the word of God.
Es un que activa la palabra.
The one that activates the word.
Por eso, porque una palabra.
Because you can have a word.
Pero si no mezcla con fe.
But if you don't mix it up with faith,
que vos así good,
that you know sure,
pues Dios avisa,
that God has said,
lo me abre puerta y ventana del cielo,
I will open up the windows and the doors of heaven. You can have that word. But if you don't have the confidence that God will do it, the word is without effect. So we need to have the confidence in God. So we can connect ourselves to the manifestation of the things we hope for. We hope for. When we have confidence in God, as I mentioned here, we depend only on Him. Not on our circumstances. Not on what we see surrounding us. Only on Him. When you have confidence in God, you have the peace. Knowing that He will do what He has promised you. But this confidence has to be developed. I can trust Sister Sulaika today. I can meet her today and get to know her today. But it's not as of today that I will start to have trust in her. It's while we are going to have a relationship with each other and we talk with each other. She talks to me back. Her attitude towards me. That will start to develop the confidence that I will have for her. Because the same way I can get to know her, but I don't have any relation with her, I don't know who she is. The same with God. To have that confidence in God, we need to know God. We need to know who God is.
Feta é regalo que Deus está a dar a cada que a nasce de novo.
Faith is the gift that God has given to everyone that has been born again.
Nós vamos Romanos 10:2-3.
Let us go to Romans
12:13.
And we see what the Bible says.
Cada nasce de novo de Deus.
Every child that's born again from God,
Deus está dando um regalo.
God has given them a gift.
And
the word says,
Pasomador de graça do Nanami, me tabisa cada de vos para não pensa mais alto de su mês, que MC pensa, mas mais bem pensa de su mês com sano juicio, de acordo com a medida de fé que Deus ha donado.
For I say, through the grace given to me, to everyone who is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly as God has dealt to each one a measure of faith.
Deus ha donado cada nós, cada de nós.
God has given every one of us
a medida de fé,
a measure of faith.
E não disse medida, dois medidas.
He didn't say one measure and a second measure.
A medida de fé.
The measure of
ora nós aceptar Jesus.
When we accept Jesus
como nosso Salvador,
as personal, our Savior, personal Savior,
e nós nasce de novo pelo Espírito de Deus.
We are born again through the Spirit of God.
Deus dá a cada de nós a medida de fé.
God gives every one of us the measure of faith.
Mas nós precisamos que Deus nunca nos dê legal para fazer algo,
because we must know that God will not let you do anything,
ou pedir para fazer algo,
or ask you to do anything.
5e
without him giving you the means through where you can accomplish that. Just as we say that without faith it is impossible to please him, so he also gives you that faith so you can please
pero nós,
but we
tem que desarrollar,
have to develop it.
Isso goes com baby tá nasce,
just like a baby is born,
e tem que crescer para grande.
She has to grow up to become an adult.
Nós também, ou nós saia MD de fé, ou nós aceita Cristo, nós nasce de novo.
We also receive the measure of faith when we are born again.
Nós também tem que desarrollar a fé.
We also have to develop that faith.
Porque se nós não desarrollar a fé,
because if we don't develop that faith,
nós não podemos agradar a Deus.
We cannot please God.
Nós somos nossa vai de glória para glória.
Because we go from glory to glory. And while we are growing, we are getting other responsibilities. The same way in the kingdom of God. While we are growing in the kingdom of God, we have to continue to edify, develop our faith. Because the battles that a newborn will get are not the same battles that one who was already 10 years born again and is truly serving God from his heart is getting. So you have to continue daily to edify that confidence in God. And it's not everyone has faith. This is very important. Put a statement before we continue. Let us go to 2 Thessalonians 3,
versículo 1 con 2.
Verse 1 and 2. Here we see that it is not everyone who has faith. Let us go and see who does not have faith.
Finalmente, Romana, hace oración para nos, para la palabra del Señor proclama rápidamente y vuelve a glorificar. Mescos que cerca vos también, y que nos vuelve a liberar de gente perverso y malvado, para sombra no tatur de fe.
Finally, brethren, pray for us that the word of the Lord may run swiftly and be glorified, just as it is with you, and that we may be delivered from unreasonable and wicked men, for not all have faith. So we see that the wicked, they don't have faith. That's why the Bible is saying, when you are born again, and it has been given to you, the measure of faith. Because people abroad, the unbelievers, they cannot think that I will have that house one day. But I don't see it. I don't have a job. Nothing that can make me get to that house. But we that know God, we know that nothing is impossible for him. And once that faith pleases him, I can have that house and houses. Because I believe to receive.
Amen.
Amen.
Tem dois tipos de fé.
There are two types of faith.
Aqui não estou falando de incredulona.
I'm not talking here about the unbelievers.
Estou falando aqui nada de nós como cristianos.
I'm talking here as about we as Christians.
Vamos ver João 20.
Let us go to John 20.
E nós a mira.
And we can see.
Onde é tipo de fé?
One of these types of faith.
24 e 25.
24 and 25.
Mas Tomás, onde é dias ele estava a chamar Dídimo, não estava tão junto com a hora Jesus sabia. E outro discípulo na antou a bise, nos admira Senhor. Mas ela bise na, se me não mira de sua mana, e marca de clavo na, e hinca, me dede de lugar de clavo na, e hinca me mana em sua costilha, me não taquere.
Now Thomas, called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said to him, "We have seen the Lord." So he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe."
Aqui na nossa mira com Tomás.
Here we can see that Thomas
estava de discípulo de Jesus.
Was a disciple of Jesus.
Ele caminha com Jesus.
He walked with Jesus.
Pero toque no aquere.
But yet he didn't believe.
Ele será mira para mim.
He had to see first.
Para ora quere.
So then he could believe.
Na nossa com outro tipo de fé.
And let us see another type of faith.
Na Romanos 4.
In Romans 4.
Nossa mira é fé de Abraão.
We see the faith of Abraham.
Essa que é fé com Deus que é para cada de nós.
This is the faith that God wants everyone to have and to walk in. And it says,
"Tó relaciona que promessa de Deus, Abraham não há dúvida do de incredulidade, mas abira forte de fé, donando glória a Deus, sendo completamente seguro que o que ele prometeu estava capaz de fazer também."
He did not waver at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strengthened in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully convicted that what he had promised, he was also able to perform. This Bible is the promises that God has for every one of us. And God doesn't want us to see
a manifestation para nos quiere,
the manifestation in order that we can believe.
Pero es que para nos quiere,
but he wants us to believe
para nos poder mirar a manifestation.
In order to see the manifestation.
Pero obviamente te apuntará.
But a lot of times you ask yourself, I ask God something, but I haven't seen it. But that's why the topic of today, you have to develop, edify the faith, the confidence that you have in God. Because if you don't develop that confidence, you cannot believe in Him.
Amen.
Amen.
Nós mira,
we have seen
que por meio de fé,
that through faith,
nós por vencer o mundo,
we can conquer the world.
Nós vamos João 15.
Let us go to John 15.
Me dá quando é a fundação para essa aliança.
I'm laying the foundation for the teaching.
Mas não me cessa.
Because we have to know.
Que coisa é fé aqui?
What is this faith?
Para nós por,
so that we can
desenvolver.
Develop it.
Mas você não pode desenvolver algo.
Because you can develop something.
Que não sabe de.
That you don't know about.
Que coisa encerra.
Or what it holds.
João 15, 7 da Bíblia.
John 17, verse 5.
Prometo 5, 4.
1 John 5:4.
And it says,
"For whatever is born of God, we are born of God." When we are born again through the Spirit of God, overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world. Our faith,
nos confianza en Dios.
Our confidence in God,
nos confianza en Dios.
Our confidence in God,
este es supremo.
He is the supreme.
E avisa que no tiene nada arriba mí.
He said there is nothing above me.
Ando Dios en cielo y tierra.
I'm the God in the heavens and on
una
earth.
Una vez nos hace DJ,
and once that we know Him,
nos di su espíritu,
and we have His spirit,
y nos da confianza,
and we have confidence in
Victoria
Him.
Victoria está segura para
Victory
nos.
Is sure for us, servant. Amen.
Luego nos van ahora na Marcos 5:25-36.
Let us go now to Mark 5:25-36.
Aqui nós dois casos, dois casos.
Here you can see two cases.
Caminha Jesus,
where Jesus
a atender com dois tipos de pessoas.
Has dealt with two type of persons.
Pero nos mira.
But we can also see
el resultado.
The results.
Então pensa na 25 minutos, ele se completa
para depois repartir. Exato, 25.
Mais importante. E um momento de Jesus, aí ela estava tendo um derrame de sangue.
Now a certain woman had a flow of blood
and
has suffered many things from many
physicians.
She had spent all she had and was no better. But rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. And immediately she was healed. And we know that Jesus has told this lady, your faith, your confidence in God, your confidence that God is the only one that can heal you, has healed you. And later on we can see he continued with Jairus. When he told him that his son died, Jesus turned and told him,
no tiene miedo,
don't fear,
pero quiere,
but believe.
Then comienza nuestra mira.
And the beginning we can see
fe,
that faith
o da querer em Deus, de confiança em Deus.
You have faith in God, you believe in God.
Pero agora é pergunta também.
But now the question comes.
É confiança aqui.
This confidence.
É fé aqui.
This faith.
Como eu desenvolvo?
How can I develop
como
it?
Como eu edifico se me tem em casa?
How can I edify it if I already have it?
Nós também era culpa edificar a fé.
We can see that to edify your faith,
o mestre estudia a palavra.
You have to study the word.
O mestre meditar a palavra.
You have to meditate the word.
E você quase oração.
And you have to pray.
E atuar.
And act.
Nós vamos ir em cada um de três partes na aqui.
We're going to go deeper in every one of these points.
Para nós vamos ir a compa meio de nas três.
So we can see that through the three of them,
nós por edificarmos fé.
We can edify our faith.
Nós vamos ir a confiança em Deus e.
We can have that confidence in God.
Não importa Kiko.
It doesn't matter what it is.
Bota queda com a confiança em Deus apesar de situação que bota dentro.
You will keep your confidence and believe in God despite everything.
E bota larga e fé e confiança e cresce cada dia de novo.
And you let that faith and confidence grow every day again.
Mas que bota dentro é prueba.
Even though you're in the test.
Mas bota dentro é tormenta.
Even though you are going through the torment.
Amen.
Amen.
Nós vamos começar com estudar a palavra.
Let us continue with studying of the word.
Fé também para medo de a palavra de Deus.
Faith comes through the word of God.
Let us
go to Romans 10:17.
Aqui na nossa mira.
And here we can see
que fé também foi entendimento.
That faith comes by hearing.
Entendimento por meio de palavra.
And by hearing
de Deus.
Of the word of God.
Ora para estudar a palavra de Deus.
When you're studying the word of God.
Mino que men lesa a palavra de Deus.
I don't mean reading the word of God.
So hope de nós da lesa a palavra.
Because
de
a lot
Deus.
Of us read the word of God.
E não dizem o que Deus quer.
And that is not what God wants.
Para vos edificar vos fé.
To edify your faith.
Vos não por lesa a palavra.
You cannot read the word.
Vos tem que estudar a palavra.
You have to study.
Vos tem que plantar semente na nosso coração.
You have to plant the seeds in your heart.
Para nós compreender
to understand good the difference between reading and studying. We can go back to the time we're going to school. When we were going to school, we learned. We study. For example, the class of economy.
Você estuda economia.
You study economy.
Palavra não como nossa.
The words that you don't know.
Você busca a significação.
You're gonna go look for their meaning.
Mesmo coisa é palavra de Deus.
The same thing in the word of God.
Palavra não como nossa compra não como nossa.
The words that you don't know, you don't understand.
Você busca um dicionário para buscar.
You're gonna go look in a dictionary so you can understand.
Mas se você disse lesse?
Because if you're just reading it.
Ah, me está como a palavra que me está baila aqui.
Oh, I don't understand that word, so just let it go on.
Pipiate palavra é clave.
But lot of times these words are the keynotes. So you can understand what God is telling you. You are studying in school to understand the theory that you are studying. And the word of God is the same. You're studying to understand what God is telling you. Because if you don't understand, you cannot apply it. We can see in 2 Timothy 2:15.
Pablo avisa Timoteo.
Paul told Timothy,
studia,
study, to show yourself approved to God. Let us go there and say what else it is saying. 2 Timothy 2:15.
Hace tu esfuerzo para presentarme mes aprobado delante de Dios, manera un trabajo con otro motivo para ti vergüenza, puta parte de palabra de verdad de una manera correcta.
Be diligent to present yourself approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Fe de mi manera de palabra.
Faith comes through the word.
O piensa que edificar la fe sin la palabra de Dios.
A lot of people want to edify their faith without the word
Pero
of God.
Pero fe también no estudia palabra.
But faith comes by studying the word.
Vamos a escuela.
Let us go back to school.
Ahora cuando estudiando voy a traer examen.
When you're studying to do your exam.
Na examen voy a traer prueba por mes.
At the exam you will prove yourself.
Para estudia.
That you studied.
Mes un curso de palabra de Dios.
And the same thing in the word of God.
Ahora voy a traer prueba na.
When you find yourself going to trials, there you will know if certainly you did study the word. There you will know if you truly understand what you studied. And there you will get to know the understanding of the word that you studied. Let us go to Mark 11. And we will see where here Jesus is saying,
Tiene fe en Dios.
Have faith in God.
De verdad me avisa vos.
And very, very, I say unto you.
Quien cubiese estero aquí.
Whoever says to this mountain,
sea quita fuginana,
be removed,
y tira de la mano,
and cast into the sea,
y no dura de su corazón,
and does not doubt in his heart,
ma quiere con lo que te avisa,
but believe that those things he says,
sabe eso so de,
will be done,
si lo guardo así pa voso,
that will be done for you.
Pensemi te avisa voso de 24.
Therefore I say to you in 24,
tu lo que voso pidi ora posso darsi oración,
whatever things you ask when you pray,
quiere que posso darisi bie,
believe that you receive them,
lo vira di voso.
And you will have
that.
And now my question is, how can you talk to a mountain which are the problems and situations in your life if you don't know the words that you have to talk against that mountain or that problem? Those words you will receive when you're studying the word of God. You say, but Shirley, how can I read all the words in the Bible? How can I remember them all? That is not your problem. There the Holy Spirit comes in. Your task is to study. Look for the signification of words. Because a lot of times we lose that part. Because we don't know the meaning of the word. When we know the meaning of the word, you will understand the complete context.